Hello students, today we will discuss the next topic of this chapter, electric charges and field, that is Coulomb's law. So what is Coulomb's law, do you know? Okay, suppose we are having two charges Q1 and Q2 separated by a distance R12. Now the force experienced by this charge Q1 is F12, it is due to Q1, and the force experienced by the charge Q2 due to Q1 is F21. Now we can say that the force between any two charges Q1, Q2 is directly proportional to the product of their magnitudes, and this force is inversely proportional to the distance, square of the distance between the two charges. Okay, now if we club both terms, if we mix both terms, we get electric force is directly proportional to Q1 Q2 upon R square. That is, if we use proportionality constant, then it is electric force is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 upon R square. This 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught is a proportionality constant here, which is also represented as K. So we can write electric force is equal to K Q1 Q2 upon R square, where K is equal to 9 × 10⁻⁹ Newton meter square per Coulomb square. Here it is very important to note this thing that epsilon naught is called the permittivity of free space. Epsilon naught is called the permittivity of free space. The value is 8.85 × 10⁻¹² Coulomb per Newton meter square. Now what is this K? K is called the dielectric constant. K is called here the dielectric constant. Okay. Now, electric force can be represented in the vectorial form like this: K Q1 Q2 upon into R vector upon cube of R vector. That is, we multiply numerator and denominator both sides by R vector. We get this value. Okay. This is Coulomb's law. So we can, in short, we can say Coulomb's law is what? The force between the two charges is directly proportional to the product of the two charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Okay. Now further, we will come on the next topic, that is multiple charges. What do you mean by multiple charges? What are multiple charges? Suppose we are having charges in quantity greater than or equal to 3. So we can say that these are multiple charges. The calculation of force, how will you calculate the force between these charges? Suppose you are having 3 or greater than 3 number of charges. What will you do? We will calculate like this: force on the first charge is given by force on the first charge due to second, plus force on the first charge due to third, plus force on the first charge due to fourth, and so on. Finally, we can say that this term will come to picture. This term will come to picture. You know this thing very well. So, this is also can be stated as the total force on the first charge is the sum of all the forces exerted by all the individual charges on the first charges. Okay. Now, what will you say about, do you know what is R12 vector here? R12 vector is what is the